The reverse crunch progression is an anterior core exercise that works from neutral to a little bit of trunk flexion as we go through the motion. So what Dan's gonna do is he's gonna set up with some sort of heavy object like a heavy kettlebell. You could even do this with a rig behind you or something that's not gonna move on you, okay? From this setup position, we're gonna take his knees up off the ground a little bit, drive his heels into his butt so he's in a nice tight position here, okay? Our first cue is gonna be to drive his low back into the ground so he's starting with an active core, and then we're just gonna pull the knees up over the elbows, thinking of using that kettlebell for a little bit of support. Good, so he's come up to this position. On the way back down, he's lowering, thinking of lowering one piece at a time. Perfect. Now our next progression is we're gonna go through a normal rep on the way up, right? So we'll reverse crunch up, slowly lower back down, and now the second that he reaches neutral here, we're gonna extend the legs out and tap the heels. And we'll give him a little bit of rest while we talk about it. So by adding that portion to it, not only have we gotten the flexion portion of the lift, but as we lower back down, we've got an anti-extension component because he's maintaining that neutral position as we extend the lever out in front of him. Now for the next two progressions, we're gonna do our standard reverse crunch on the way up. But now on the way down, we're gonna take one leg, straighten it out, and now we've got a longer lever that we're gonna lengthen all the way down to the ground. So again, we're increasing the demand on the eccentric portion. Our final progression, he's gonna do a reverse crunch up. We're gonna drive both legs out, and from this long position, we're gonna lower his whole body down towards the ground, trying to maintain a straight body line as he goes.